Face the board, face the board. Let's look what's on the board. Raise your hands if you know which form of transportation this is. Mark? Yes, it's a school bus. And we travel to school with a school bus. Anyone perhaps knows what the following form of transportation is? Anyone? Kaylee? It's a car. Yes, it's a car. Beautiful, Kaylee. Anyone knows what this little boy is doing? What is this little boy driving on? Anyone? Kate, it's a bicycle. Well done, Kate. And who knows what are these two children doing? Can anyone tell me what they're doing? Raise your hands. Remember to raise your hands before you answer. Okay. Sean? They're walking. Next group. Who travels to school by car every day? Who drives with their mummies and daddies to school every day? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 learners travel to school by car every day. And moving on. Who travels to school by bike every day? It's a good form of exercise, cycling that bike. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 of you guys travel to school by bike every day. And last one. Who walks to school every day? It's also a good form of exercise. Who walks to school every day? Especially if you live close to the school. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 learners walk daily. 7. Well done, guys. As you can see, we all travel by different forms of transport. So with this data, we can draw a bar graph. Who knows what a bar graph? A bar graph is a chart you can use to display what we have just counted here. So we can take this information and draw it on a bar graph. Starting with, we can use these numbers we collected here and draw them in another way by using a bar graph. Who knows what a bar graph is? Anyone? Raise your hand if you know what a bar graph is. No one. Let me tell you
what a bar graph is.
So, a bar graph usually has a y-axis and an x-axis. So this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. The y-axis will always contain the numbers we have collected. So this will always be the numbers we have collected, which means it'll be the frequency. And our x-axis is always what numbers are we using? Numbers of what did we collect? And we collected numbers of transport. So then we write the transport on the x-axis. Then, to take this data and write it on here, we start by writing the transport, forms of transport. So, firstly, what form of transport is this again? It's a bus. Then we write bus. Which form of transport is the second one? It's a car. And the third one, a bicycle. And the last one is walking. Walking. On the frequency side, we said we're going to have to plot the numbers of learners who do each one of them. So we're going to start from one. 1, 2, 13. 13, because our highest number here is 13. So I'm going to write these down. 2, 3, 11, 12, and 13. So now for plotting this data, you're going to have to be very, very smart and very, very cautious. You won't want to make a mistake. Okay, with the bus, who can tell me how many learners take the bus to school every day? 11, exactly. So on the Y axis, you go to 11 and then you draw your bar at 11, because 11 learners take the bus daily. Exactly the same with the car. Because 30 learners take the car, we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we're plotting at 30, and you must look, it must be in range with the car. So we're going to move a little. And then we draw our graph that represents the amount of learners which goes to school by car daily. Moving on, we're going to do the same with learners who travel by bicycle. How many learners travel by bicycle? 5. Beautiful. So we're going to count on our frequency side again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And remember, we are plotting for the bike. So we're looking where the bike is. There we see, okay, it's here. And that's where we draw our bar. And for the last one, how many learners walk to school daily? 7 is correct. So we're going to count again on our Y axis. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we look for the walking sign, 7, and we draw our bar. Who can tell me why we call this a bar graph? Anyone? Because it has bars. Each bar represents the amount of children who travel by the specific transport daily. Oh, sorry. Okay. So as you can see, we can use a bar graph to represent how you travel to school daily. Stop. Can I face the board again quickly? Thank you. Thank you. Who can tell me what they see on the board, on this worksheet? It shapes. Beautiful. It shapes. Who can tell me what kind of shapes they see? Raise your hand if you can see any type of shape you recognize. Raise your hand. Ben? A circle. Beautiful, Ben. This is a circle. Kayla? A triangle. Beautiful. This is a triangle. Does anyone see any other shapes they recognize? Yes, Keith. A square. Beautiful. I can see a square as well. Anyone else? There's one last shape that no one mentioned. Anyone? Okay. shape do you see?
A rectangle. Beautiful, guys. I can see you all know your shapes very, very well. As you can see, the shapes are out of order. And someone asked me if we can please sort the shapes out for them. Okay. They want to know how many triangles are in here, how many circles are in here, how many squares are in here, and how many rectangles are in here. Can you guys help me with that? Okay, so starting, let's count the triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many triangles did we count? 4, that's correct. So we are going to write the number 4 here. See, it's next to the word triangle. We found 4 triangles. Moving on, what's the next shape? A circle. Can we count all the circles together? Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 circles as well. So, how many circles are there? 4. We're going to write the number 4 where the circles are. On. And the next shape is a square. Remember, a square has all sides that are equal. And a rectangle has 2 opposite sides that are equal. Remember not to confuse the two. So looking for all sides that are equal, we're going to count. Start counting. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are 4 squares. Last but not least, let's count the rectangles. And let's not forget that rectangles have 2 opposite sides that are equal. So let's look for the rectangles. 1, 2, 3, 4. They are 4 as well. Who can tell me what they see here? What pattern do they see? Yes, correct. All the shapes are equally numbered. There are 4 triangles, 4 squares, 4 circles, and 4 rectangles. So we are going to use these numbers and we are going to draw a bar graph. Who still remembers what a bar graph looks like? Anyone? Yes, of course, it has bars. That's why we call it a bar graph. So remember where we start by drawing our y-axis first. And then, who can tell me what comes next? Correct, the x-axis. So, what does the y-axis represent? Who can tell me? Of course, the numbers. So, what do we call those numbers? Frequencies. Yes, do not forget to write it. Frequencies. And if we are to number the y-axis, until what number will it go? Like, which number will be the biggest number? Okay, 4, but we can use bigger numbers, so let's use 5. So counting, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 numbers. Moving on the x-axis. Who can tell me which data the x-axis represents? The shapes, correct. So we write down shapes at the bottom? Because we always have to name our Y and our X axis so that the person reading the data can know what's happening. So, we're gonna draw a triangle here, a square, a circle, and a rectangle. So, who can tell me what will happen next? Anyone? Now we're gonna start plotting this data. For the triangle, how many triangles do we have? Let's not forget we must enter the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Let's not forget to look at the numbers here and plot it here. So, moving on. How many triangles do we have? 4. Beautiful. So we go to 4, look at triangles, and then you draw it. How many squares do we have? 4 as well. We are very lucky to have the same amount here. So you got to square 4, and then you draw your bar. You guys are going to complete this bar graph. If you struggle, please raise your hand and Ben will come assist you. Can all the row leaders please come to the front so we can hand out all these worksheets? Thank you, learners.
With this following game, we're going to divide the class into 4 groups. Each group will choose 2 members from their group to represent them in the beanbag tossing game. It's going to work like this. The 2 learners that each group chooses, they're going to stand opposite each other 5 meters apart with a bucket next to them. One of the students' buckets will be filled with beanbags. The other bucket will be empty. Students will have 20 seconds to toss the beanbag to their partner, but they cannot let the beanbag touch the floor and they cannot cross the line that is drawn in front of them.
Me water, holy water, quench this fire. Pour me water, some holy water, make it quench this fire. Holy water.
Okay, welcome back, learners. Everyone take their seats, please. Everyone be seated. Everyone take their seats. That was a fun game, wasn't it? Who was the winning team? Yes, it was group 3. Well done, group 3. You guys did great. Okay, now, who can remember with how many beanbags group 1 had in their winning bucket? In their winning bucket, they had 5 beanbags. So, Ben's going to give out each and every one of you a worksheet like this. And then we're going to draw a pictograph. A pictograph is a graph that is a representation of pictures. So, we are going to draw beanbags because we played with beanbags. That's great. So, group 1 had 5 beanbags in their winning bucket. So, how many beanbags are we going to draw by group 1's number of beanbags? Who can tell me? 5, exactly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, Mem already drew the first 5 for you as an example. So, group 2, how many beanbags did you guys have in your buckets? Oh, 3. It's not too bad. Well done, guys. 3. So, how many beanbags are we going to draw next to group 2? Who can tell me? 3. So, So we're going to draw 1, 2, 3 bean bits. And remember, you can color it with any color you like. Group three, the winning team. How many bean bags did you guys have in your winning bucket? 7! Well done, guys. Well done. So we're going to draw 7 of these bean bags here. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bean bags that are going to be drawn here. Group four. How many bean bags was in you guys' winning bucket? It was 4. Well done, guys. So yeah, we're going to draw how many bean bags? 4, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4. Who will be able to do this worksheet, this easy peasy worksheet in no time? Anyone who's a very smart learner, who will be able to do this? Every one of you, because all of you are smart. Let's get started. Can all the role leaders please come to the front so I can give them the worksheet so they can hand it out to everyone? Okay, the game was fun, so we're going to use that game and we are going to draw a bar graph. Now, each and everyone here knows how to draw a bar graph, don't you guys? Who doesn't know how to draw a bar graph? Please raise your hand. See, because all of you are smart, you guys know how to draw a bar graph. So, you're going to draw the bar graph on a piece of paper. Then I will give out this paper in a later stage. And remember, who can tell me what a bar graph always has? A y-axis, and the y-axis goes like this. And the x-axis. And what does the y-axis represent? The frequency, which is the number. What does the x-axis represent? That will be the bean bags. Okay, guys, I know you guys can draw these because we've done quite a few examples. And if you struggle, raise your hand and Mam will come assist you. Group leaders, can you please collect the worksheets that we were busy with now? Is everyone done? Okay, we'll give you a few minutes, Caitlin. Role learners, can you please collect the rest of the learners' worksheets and please leave it on my table? And it's almost home time, so for homework, we are going to do... I like doing fun activities too, so you guys are going to have to go home and ask 10 people which fruit they prefer between an apple, a banana, an orange, and a pear. For example, let's say Katie goes home this afternoon. Katie, and she finds out that 2 people like pears, and she will draw a number 2 here at the pear. She finds out 3 people like apples. They prefer apples over any of these fruits. The number 5 will be written there. When Katie's done, she has to draw a pictograph. Who still remembers what a pictograph is? Anyone? Yes, it's a graph that shows us data with pictures. Yes. So, as you can see, this is an example. If 3 people chose grapes, our Katie would have drawn 3 people next to grapes. So, if 5 people chose apples, how many people are Katie gonna draw next to apples? Can anyone tell me? 5, that's correct! And Say, for instance, two people chose bananas. How many people are Katie going to draw next to bananas? Two people. Very, very well. And this goes for the oranges. How many? Well, so this is a very fun game. You get to draw. You get to color in all the fruits. Color in the fruits on this side as well. And for the last part of the activity, we are going to draw a barber. And I know by now, everyone is excellent in drawing a bar graph. So we are going to use these numbers and these fruits to draw a bar graph. And I'm sure Mel doesn't have to explain that again. Do I? Okay, I'll just go through it once again. Remember, the bar graph always has a y-axis and a x-axis. The y-axis always represents the numbers, which are the frequencies. Beautiful, guys. Correct. You guys are excellent. The x-axis always represents the fruits. So we're going to write the fruits here. We're going to write fruits here and all the fruits here so we can plot the data. Thank you very much, guys. Remember to color in